Let's see some examples for positive catalyst. N2 gas plus 3H2 gas gives rise to 2NH3 gas. You know, in this reaction, iron is used as catalyst. Which one is catalyst? Iron. Here, iron is positive catalyst. Positive catalyst means increases the rate of reaction. Second one, 2SO2 gas plus O2 gas gives rise to 2SO3 gas. Here, vanadium pentoxide V2O5 is used as catalyst. So, here SO2 plus O2 SO3. The first reaction is the preparation of ammonia by Haber's method. The second reaction is preparation of sulfur trioxide from that sulfuric acid by contact method. This is Haber's method. This is contact process. Similarly, see one more example. NH3 gas plus O2 gives rise to NO gas plus H2O. Okay, take 2 moles, here 3 moles, to balance it to 2 moles. Total oxygen is 2 plus 3, 5, so 5 by 2 moles here. In this, platinum is the catalyst. Fourth one, in the hydrogenation of alkenes, CH2 double bond CH2, it is ethene plus hydrogen gives rise to nickel plus ethane. So, this is an example for hydrogenation of alkenes. Sixth one, H2 gas plus, here also these are all gases, gas. H2 gas plus O2 gas gives rise to 2H2O liquid. Here, to balance the reaction, take 2 moles of H2 gas. In this reaction also, platinum is the catalyst. See, in all these five reactions, positive catalysts, the mentioned are positive catalysts: iron, vanadium pentoxide, platinum, nickel, platinum. Okay, these are all positive catalysts. Have a look on some negative catalysts. You know, negative catalysts are also called inhibitors because they inhibit the reaction, they stop the reaction. Some catalysts may decrease the rate of reaction, or some catalysts may just simply stop the reaction. So, negative catalysts, those are. See some examples in which negative catalysts are there. First one, hydrogen peroxide. It's a liquid, but it is an unstable liquid. So, it decomposes to 2H2O liquid plus O2 gas. You know, in this reaction, the negative catalysts are either dilute acids or glycols. They act as a negative catalyst. That means hydrogen peroxide is very unstable liquid. It decomposes to water and oxygen. That's why it is to be preserved from its decomposition. So, for that preservation, we have to add some negative catalyst. If we add their positive catalyst, what happens? Decomposition is increased further. But hydrogen peroxide, you know, it is commercially used as antiseptic. So to preserve its antiseptic action, its decomposition must be prevented. Otherwise, what happens? All hydrogen peroxide decomposes to water. There will be water in the bottle instead of hydrogen peroxide. Water is not antiseptic. So, to preserve the antiseptic action of hydrogen peroxide, we must prevent the decomposition. So, for that, to hydrogen peroxide, dilute acids or glycols are added. They act as negative catalysts, also inhibitors. So, here in this case, for hydrogen, to stop the hydrogen peroxide decomposition, the compounds are added, na? Some compounds. Those are called stabilizers in this case. Why they are said to be stabilizers? Because they stabilize hydrogen peroxide. They stabilize hydrogen peroxide from its decomposition. That's why dilute acids, glycols, they are called negative catalysts, inhibitors, stabilizers. With different names, we can call them. Second one. See, chloroform, CHCl3, which is a liquid, it combines with oxygen in air to form chloroform, oxidized. Chloroform is oxidized with air to COCl2, a poisonous gas. Along with it, HCl is also formed, HCl gas. So, see this reaction, chloroform in air oxidized to phosgene, very poisonous gas it is. When it is inhaled in breathing, what happens? It simply, there is CO, na? It decomposes to CO and Cl2. That CO, carbon monoxide, blocks the hemoglobin molecule. So, in that way, it decreases the transportation of oxygen from lungs to various tissues of our body. So, chloroform, to prevent its oxidation, which one is used? 1% ethyl alcohol is used as a negative catalyst. Which one? 1% ethyl alcohol is used as negative catalyst for this. This negative catalyst prevent the reaction. Not only that, if any phosgene is formed during the reaction, that poisonous phosgene is converted into non-poisonous ethyl carbonate. So, in that way, chloroform is prevented from its oxidation. Do you know what happens when chloroform is not prevented from its oxidation? Chloroform is used as anesthetic. So, when the chloroform is not pure, that means it is contaminated with some COCl2 by oxidation. This phosgene decomposes in body to CO, that CO blocks the hemoglobin molecules, and in that way, what happens? Transportation of oxygen to tissues will be stopped. So, that leads to different symptoms. Okay, so in that way, chloroform must be pure. So, for that, 1% ethyl alcohol is added as a negative catalyst. See the third example. You know, in the burning of petrol, there is a compound tetraethyl lead, formula C2H54, tetraethyl lead. In the burning of petrol, tetraethyl lead is used as, what is that, negative catalyst. If a negative catalyst is not there, what happens? rapid burning of petrol takes place. Rapid burning, explosive burning, that leads to knocking. So tetraethyl lead, when it is mixed with petrol, what happens is it slows down the burning process. Because of that, knocking will be decreased. So the tetraethyl lead added to petrol is not only a negative catalyst here, it acts as anti-knocking agent. What is that? Anti-knocking agent. That means I said na earlier, petrol during its burning, it gives some knocking. That knocking is prevented by tetraethyl lead. But nowadays tetraethyl lead is not using. Some other substitutes are there because of a toxic element lead is. So it is very toxic element. It is introduced into the atmosphere through smoke from the vehicles. That's why nowadays its use is limited. So these are some examples for negative catalysts. These are all positive catalysts. These are all negative catalysts.